In this sewing tutorial, I will show you how to make a dog poop bag holder or dog waste bag dispenser. It's an easy sewing project and the holder attaches easily to a dog's leash. It will make your walks with your dog much more convenient. No more searching through your pockets for a stray poop bag. This dog poop bag holder keeps the bags accessible and organized. It has a zipper so you can load up bags and then secure them. When you need to take out a baggie, just grab it through the opening and pull it out one at a time. The front opening is big enough to allow the bags to come out, but not that big so they fall out. You can make the strap easily attachable to any type of leash, so you will never have to worry about losing it. All you need is some fabric, a sewing machine, some basic supplies, and a little bit of know-how. I will give you all the instructions you need to make this handy little holder. They are also perfect as a small gift for any dog owner. You can customize them with fun colors and cute fabrics. What you will need to make this holder? Fabric. I used quilting cotton. Thicker fabric can be also used, like canvas, vinyl. You won't need much, just scrap fabric. My piece of fabric was about 10 by 10 inches, but a smaller piece can be used. Piece of quilt bedding or fusible fleece. You will need it only if you decide to use quilting cotton to make fabric sturdy. And if you use vinyl for this project, you won't need bedding or fusible fleece. Zipper, regular, minimum 7 inches long. You can cut it if you have bigger zippers. One grommet, 1 inch size. I bought them from Amazon, 8 pieces. Snap hook or swivel hook or lobster claw. So you can attach the poop bag holder to the leash. Small amount of fill to put inside if you decide to make the poop bag holder in the shape of a bone. Bag holder pattern template. If you want to make the bag holder in the shape of a bone, then you can download a free printable PDF file from my resource library. For the other bag, I just used a rectangle shape. My pattern is free for my subscribers, and if you subscribe to my weekly newsletter, you can download it from my site right away. Dog waste bags. I recommend these ones. Earth rated dog poop bags. 270 extra thick and strong poop bags. They are much thicker than the ones you buy at the store. Honestly, I have never seen a product that has more than 150,000 five-star reviews. Step 1. Prepare the template. Print the PDF pattern if you want to make it in the shape of a bone. Or prepare the rectangle. I used an index card. Just cut 3/4 inch from one side. So the size of my paper rectangle is 4 3/16 by 3 inches. This size worked really well for the poop bags I bought from Amazon. They are 2 1/4 by 1 1/8. But if you have different bags, you might want to adjust your template. Step 2. Quilt the fabric attaching bedding. But this is totally optional. If you use quilting cotton fabric, you need to make it thicker. One way of doing it is to use bedding and quilt it. I like to use my embroidery machine to quilt it. The quilting stitches perfectly attach the bedding to the fabric. You can also use fusible interfacing or fusible fleece. The size of fabric I quilted was about 10 by 10 inches. Step 3. Cut the fabric. I cut 2 rectangles for the front and back of the holder. Their size is a bit bigger than the templates, about 5 by 7 inches. And after that, I cut one of the rectangles in half lengthwise. Cut also a small rectangle for attaching the snap hook, 2.5 or 3 inches by 1 inch. This is for the loop the holder hangs from. Step 4. Attach a zipper and sew the loop. Lay a zipper right side down on one of the smaller rectangles and pin it. Make sure you align the edges. Go to your sewing machine and stitch. Seam allowances are about 1/8 of an inch. You can use a special zipper foot if you have it, but a regular presser foot is good too. That's what I used. Pin another part of the zipper, aligning all edges, and stitch too. Press. Use pressing cloth so you don't destroy the zipper. Top stitch the fabric edges next to the zipper. Sew also the strap. For this, fold a small rectangle lengthwise and stitch, keeping 1/8 of an inch seam allowances. Turn it right side out using a safety pin or a bodkin. Press it and top stitch along the edge. Step 5. Insert the grommet. You don't need any special tools for this. The grommet just snaps together. The package has a template for cutting a hole in the fabric. Position the template in the center of the fabric rectangle and trace the circle with a fabric marker or even a regular pencil. Cut out the hole. You will see that the grommet has two parts. One has the right center and a few circles, and the other has prongs. Place the right center of the grommet in the hole from one side of the fabric rectangle. In my case, I put this part of the grommet under the wrong side of the fabric. On the other side, position the prong side of the grommet over the raised center. Press down to secure. Step 6. Sew the front and back of the dog waist bag holder together. Open the zipper halfway for turning the holder right side out. Now you need to add the loop with the swivel hook. Take the small strap and thread it through the D-ring in the swivel hook. Fold it in half. Pin the raw edges together. Position the loop in the center point of one side so that the raw edges are matching and the swivel hook is inside the bag. Place the front with the grommet and zipper it back right sides together and pin, preparing it for stitching. Make sure they stay together and don't move. Pin in place. Make sure you pin together unzipped ends of the zipper as close as you can. Even overlap them just a bit. Use the template to see how you should cut it, making sure that the zipper is centered. Add 3/8 of an inch seam allowances to the rectangle and cut the fabric. If you have excess on your zipper, you can cut that off too. if you are using the bone template, you don't need to add seam allowances as they are included. Stitch using 3/8 of an inch seam allowances. Secure stitches well around the zipper. Sew over the zipper ends a few times. Step 7. Finish the dog waist bag dispenser. So this holder is sewn together and almost ready. Trim close to stitches. Snip corners to reduce bulk inside the holder. Turn the back holder right side out. Use a pencil or a chopstick to push out the corners well. If you are making the bone holder, you might need to add some filling material, like the putting pillows and toys, into the side so that the poop bag stays in the middle. You may also want to check out my other project, a DIY dog bandana. So go ahead and watch the tutorial where I will show you how to make an over-the-collar dog bandana. It's unusual, so, because it has small LED lights inside.